Hi, welcome to my channel Mathematics Made Easy by Mary MJ. Here I'm discussing class 12, chapter 2, inverse trigonometric functions. In chapter 1, we have already studied about inverse of a function. For a function to exist inverse, it should be 1, 1 and on 2. That all we have discussed in the first chapter itself. In this chapter, we shall study about some of the restrictions of domains and range of trigonometric functions. So in that case, then only it will exist. We have to ensure the existence. That's why we are restricting the domains. So we know what is y is equal to sin x and or what is a graph of y is equal to sin x. So I have shown you here, this is the graph of y is equal to sin x. And we know that sin x is from the real number set to minus 1, 1. You can see its maximum value, it is between minus 1 and 1. The range set is between all the values for every real number r, it is between minus 1 and 1. So sin x is from real numbers to minus 1, 1, closed interval minus 1, 1. Whereas cos x, it is also from the real number set. It is a function also. These all are functions because all the x elements are having different images. So these are 1, 1, 1, 1 functions. And if I am restricting between, so I am restricting these values, let it be from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. For sin x, I am taking from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. That's one complete. So here, if I am reversing the function, we'll get it as y is equal to sin inverse x. So the graph of sin inverse x will be like this. So in that case, what happens to its domain and range? If sin x is from, we are taking from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, I am only restricting the domain from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So sin x is from, instead of real number set, I am taking from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 to closed interval minus 1, 1. So what happens to sin inverse x? If y is equal to, that is sin x is from closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 to closed interval minus 1, 1, then sin inverse x, you can see where it is ranging. Sin inverse x, the x values it is ranging between minus 1 and 1. So here this range comes to the side, it becomes the domain. So it is from minus 1 to 1 to closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 to pi by 2 to pi by 2. Yeah. So sin inverse x is from minus pi by 2 to minus pi by 2 pi by 2 to closed interval minus 1, 1. So sin inverse x will be from minus 1, 1 to minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2. This is the range. This is the range of the function. Same way we can find out what for cos x, tan x, cosec x, cot x and all. So this is the range of sin inverse x, or we call it as the principal value branch. So same way for each sin inverse x, cos inverse x, tan inverse x, cosec inverse x and all the inverse trigonometric functions, we can find out what is the principal value branch of each. So the value of the inverse trigonometric functions which lies in the range of the principal value branch, principal branch, is called the principal value of that inverse trigonometric function. What is it? The value of an inverse trigonometric function which lies in the range of the principal branch is called the principal value of that inverse trigonometric function. So you should study what is the principal value branch for each of the inverse trigonometric functions. So I'll write it here, which are the inverse trigonometric functions, principal value branches. For sine inverse, as I've told you, sine inverse 6, it is from closed interval minus 1, 1 to closed interval minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2. So its range should be between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Then cos inverse x, it is from again minus 1, 1 to closed interval 0 comma pi. Since here you can see for sine inverse x, this up to this only we are taking, we have restricted from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So in between them we can see that minus 1 to 1 to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So sine inverse x, its range is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Cos inverse x, its range is 0 to pi, closed interval. Then what about cosec inverse x? It is from the real number set minus open interval minus 1, 1 to closed interval minus pi by 2, pi by 2, minus set 0. Same way, all the inverse trigonometric, that range you have to study it. Then what about sec inverse x? Sec inverse x is r minus ordered pair minus 1, 1 to closed interval 0, pi minus pi by 2. These are the range set. Then tan inverse x. Tan inverse x, it is from r to open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And cot inverse x, it is from again r to open interval 0 comma pi. So these are the principal value branches, or it is the range. So if it is asked to find the principal value of sine inverse 1 by root 2, we have to get the answer between this, between the range or between this principal branch. So that is what we have to check it. So I'll show you one example how to find out the principal value. So find the principal value of, find the principal value of sine inverse 1 by root 2. So in order to find out the principal value, we have to take sine inverse 1 by root 2 is equal to y. Then take sine inverse to this side, it becomes sine y is equal to 1 by root 2. Then we know that the principal value branch of sine inverse is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. It is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And what is 1 by root 2? For which value of sine we will get it as 1 by root 2? It is sine pi by 4. So sine y is equal to sine pi by 4, or y is equal to pi by 4, which is in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So the principal value is pi by 4. Then moving on to the next one. So we have to check whether it is coming in the given principal value branch. Then next one, that is exercise 2.1 questions. That first question, sine inverse minus 1 by 2. So how to find out sine inverse minus 1 by 2? Consider this as x or y. We are finding out the range, so y. So sine inverse minus 1 by 2 is equal to y, or we can write sine y is equal to minus 1 by 2. Then that is equal to minus, for which value of sine we'll get it as 1 by 2? For which value of sine we'll get it as 1 by 2? It is 30, sine 30, or sine pi by 6. And since the principal value branch of sine inverse is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, how can we write this angle? Minus sine pi by 6 can be written as sine of minus pi by 6. sine of minus pi by 6. This minus sine pi by 6 can be written as sine of minus pi by 6. And sine y equal to sine of minus pi by 6. So what is the value of y? Y is equal to minus pi by 6, which is in between the interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, which is the principal value branch. So we can say that the principal value of sine inverse minus 1 by 2 is pi by 6. Then next one. Next, another question from the same exercise. Tan inverse minus root 3. Tan inverse minus root 3, we can give it as y. And that means tan y. I am taking this tan inverse to this side. You are getting tan y is equal to minus root 3. Or that is equal to minus tan. For which value of tan we are getting it as root 3? For which value of tan? It is pi by 3. Means tan 60 is root 3. So minus tan pi by 3. Again, we know that the principal value branch of tan is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So I can write this as tan of minus pi by 3. This side it is tan y. That means y is equal to minus pi by 3, which is an element of minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Here the principal value branch is between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Therefore, pi by 3, minus pi by 3 is lying between them. So, we are getting the principal value there. Then, next one, cos inverse of minus 1 by 2. Cos inverse of minus 1 by 2, first you should know what is the principal value branch. It is between 0 to pi, closed interval 0 to pi. So cos inverse of minus 1 by 2, let it be y. So cos y is equal to minus 1 by 2. And for which value of cos you are getting it as minus 1 by 2? It is minus, you can keep this minus here. Then cos 60 degree, that is cos pi by 3. So, cos y is equal to minus cos pi by 3. So, here anyway the principal value branch is between 0 to pi. So, the angle should come between this. How can you know? If I am taking this negative, it will not come between 0 to pi. So, how can you make it between 0 and pi? You know that we have studied identities, that is cos of pi minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. So minus cos pi by 3, you can change it to a positive value by using this identity. So cos pi minus pi by 3. What is cos pi minus pi by 3? It is cos 3 pi minus pi is cos 2 pi by 3. So equating both, we are getting y is equal to 2 pi by 3, which is in between 0 to pi. Yeah. So that is the principal value branch. So in that interval itself, that principal value should come. Okay. So next one. Next question. Sec inverse 2 by root 3. Let it be y. So sec y is equal to 2 by root 3. Or taking the reciprocal, that is sec y means 1 by cos y. Or cos y can be written as root 3 by 2. For which value of cos you will get it as root 3 by 2. It is 30, cos 30 or cos pi by 6. It is equal to cos pi by 6. Therefore, y is equal to pi by 6, which is in between 0 to pi. So, that's it is coming in the principal value branch itself. Now, next one. Cos inverse of minus 1 by root 2. Take it as y. So, cos y equal to minus 1 by root 2. That is minus, for which value of cos we are getting it as 1 by root 2? It is cos pi by 4. And since negative value for cos it is a principal value branches between 0 to pi, we cannot take negative. We have to make it as positive. How can you make it as positive? Cos pi minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. So here minus cos theta means cos minus cos pi by 4. So this side we can make it as cos pi minus pi by 4. This is equal to cos pi minus pi by 4, which is equal to cos 3 pi by 4. That is, cos y is equal to cos pi by 4, or y is equal to 3 pi by 4, which is an element of closed interval 0 comma pi. So we are checking whether it is coming between the principal value branch, then only we can say that this is the principal value. Principal value should lie in the principal value branch. Now, next one, we have to find out the value. Find the value of tan inverse 1 plus cos inverse minus 1 by 2 plus sin inverse minus 1 by 2. So first each one we can take it. First take tan inverse 1. Tan inverse 1 means it is pi by 4. Directly we know it is pi by 4. Then what about cos inverse minus 1 by 2? Cos inverse minus 1 by 2 we can take it as some variable here. Cos inverse minus 1 by 2 is equal to y, or cos y is equal to minus 1 by 2. Then for which value of cos we will get it as 1 by 2, that is minus cos, it is for 60, so pi by 3. Then make it as positive, that is cos pi minus pi by 3, which is equal to cos 2 pi by 3. So second one, that is instead of cos inverse minus 1 by 2, we will get it as cos 2 pi by 3. And what about the third one? Third one, sine inverse minus 1 by 2. Since the principal value branch of sine inverse, it is between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2, we can say that this can be written as 30 degree. For 1 by 2, it is 30. So, 1 negative sine, so minus pi by 6 will be the value of sine inverse minus 1 by 2. So, we can add up all these. So, LHS can be written as tan inverse 1 is pi by 4. Then, cos inverse minus 1 by 2 is 2 pi by 3. And the last one is minus pi by 6. So we have to simplify this. How can we simplify? So 4 into 3 into 6. Denominator we can take it as 4 into 6. 24 is the LCM. So we can make 24 as the denominator. So here to make 24 as the denominator, whole divided by 24. So here 6 pi, then here to make 24 into 8, so plus 16 pi, then here minus 4 pi, that is equal to 22, or 6 pi plus 12, 6 plus 12, 6 plus 12 is 18, 18 pi by 24. What is common in both? 6 is common here, 6 here 3 times, 6 here 4 times. So the answer will be 3 pi by 4. So we have to check whether it is coming in the principal value branch or not. So if it is not coming in the principal value branch, we have to bring it to that branch. It is by using any of the identities. We have studied all, so many identities, cos pi minus x, cos 2 pi minus x, which all is the identity we have to use, that you have to apply. So the remaining, that is next coming in portions, it is properties, that we'll take in the next video. Thank you for watching my video. Those who haven't subscribed, please like, share and subscribe, and also click on the bell icon for more updates and notifications. Bye.